Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Dactron here, and I'm back with another video. And in this one, we're playing The Wolf Among Us, and we're going to figure out if Big B is going to make his appointment with the dentist office, because there's nothing else it could possibly be. And we'll figure it out right now.
Okay. What would I need to do?
I need 150. It's not good to be short.
Okay. Oh, I don't...
Wait here for a second.
Not 207?
You'll think of something.
The open arms. This is where they met.
Enjoy your stay. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Wow. Thank you. Sheriff.
Keep your pants on, buddy. You have to check in first if you want a room. So come on, mosey on back and we'll get you set up.
Why can't I go upstairs? What's going on up there?
Oh, you. I work here, okay? I work the front desk. It's to help pay rent. So, now you know. I know I should have told somebody. But Beast would lose his mind if you knew.
You should really tell Beast. He's worried about you.
Bigby, I have to say, that night when you saw me, I really didn't appreciate you telling Beast when I expressly asked you not to. So, what are you doing here? Oh, you have a key.
Someone else was murdered last night.
I heard.
The victim was someone who worked at the Pudding and Pie, Lily. She, come around here ever?
Oh, yes, the troll. I did see her. I mean, you know, we never really spoke, but she came off a tad intimidating.
Have you seen Snow White down here? Or maybe somebody glamored as her?
You know, it's funny. I did see someone who I thought looked a lot like her, but... she didn't say anything when she saw me, even though she knew that I saw her. I just assumed it wasn't Snow and went about my business.
Thanks.
Wait. It'll be better if anyone sees you, that they at least see you with me, so they know that I didn't let you just wander around by yourself. 5 minutes, please.
We'll see, beauty.
Just be ready to act like I'm trying to kick you out.
That won't be hard.
Nope. Pretty simple. Self-explanatory.
Listen, Bigby. I assume you'll be filing some kind of an official report or something. Which is fine, it's just that I was wondering if I need to be in it. Do you have to mention my name? I mean, it's not like Beast would ever see your report. It's just...
It's not much of a report if I start picking and choosing which facts to include.
I see. Well, here we are. Which one was it?
You have keys to these rooms?
I thought you had a key.
Not to this one.
Hold on, Bigby. I can't just let you go into any room you want. Seriously, what if someone found out?
I could just break in the door if you prefer.
No, don't! I'll help you. Just don't break anything.
I don't know what her problem is then.
Well, that's weird. This key is supposed to open every room in the building, but... it's not working.
Beauty!
Ah, shit.
Beast?
Bigby? How could you do this to me?
No, sweetie, no. Wait a minute.
How could you do this? We've been together through everything. I took care of you. I love-
It's not what you think. Please.
You're cheating on me! With him?
No, no, Beast. I promise I'm not. I'm helping him. That's all.
I'll bet! I'm sure you help each other just great!
Beast, stop this. Right now. This isn't the way to handle things.
What do you know? You don't have anybody! What the fuck is wrong with you? She's my wife!
Beast, listen to me. There's nothing going on. I'm not-
Hey.
Bastard! I guess I finally see you for who you are.
Stop! Stop it!
You said you saw her that night. I should have fucking known.
Listen to your wife. Just calm down and-
Beast!
Okay, here we go.
What the hell do you think you're doing? You aren't even listening to me!
She's my wife, Bigby!
I told you! Just stop! Please! Leave him be! This is my fault!
Get off!
Bigby, no! Don't hurt him!
Ugh. Dad blasted. I got him.
Shit, Bigby.
What have you done?
What? What is this? Bigby.
Look what you did to the door. You can't just act like this whenever
Stand back. You don't want to see this.
Holy crap.
Beauty, stay in the hall.
What? Why? What's going on? Oh my god.
Don't touch anything.
Is this?
Lily met her client here. Mr. Smith, whoever he is.
And then?
Must have happened right here.
Jesus.
Last night?
Yeah.
I was on shift last night.
On shift? Beauty, what?
I'm not a prostitute, you idiot. I work the front desk.
Did you notice anything out of the ordinary? There might have been some loud noises.
I don't know. I mean, loud noises aren't out of the ordinary. I didn't hear anyone screaming or anything like that, but shouldn't I have? It just seemed like a total...
totally normal night. How is that even possible? There's so much blood.
Go lock the front door. Keep people out of the hallway. I need you to be sure no one comes in here. This is a crime scene, okay?
But...
Just do what he says. I'll explain later, okay? Bigby, what kind of a person could do something like this?
That's exactly what I'm about to try to find out.
I can't believe this.
Do all the rooms have these same clocks with a built-in cassette player?
I think so, yes.
Looks like she was lying down when she was killed. Flowers were already here.
How do you know that?
Blood pattern. Also, I'd say the body was dragged off the foot of the bed. There.
The body. Jesus. You could say she. Poor girl. I just can't even imagine. What is that?
It's a book about Snow White. Or about the Mundy version of her story, anyway.
The whole book is about her?
Yeah.
Why is she in a glass coffin?
This is the part where she's in a deep sleep, but they think she's dead.
What's it mean? Why mark the page where she's sleeping?
I think he made up the bed to match the coffin in the picture. Flowers, too. He'd have had Lily lie down.
I connected the evidence!
This.
You mean just before?
In the story, that's when someone comes to kiss her. That's our Mr. Smith.
This is creepy. The coffin and the weird fixation on Snow. What the hell is wrong with this guy?
A lot. Okay, we got some other stuff here.
It's a huff and puff.
I thought you were the only one who smoked that crap brand.
Apparently not. He brought wine.
Classy.
Someone's been rough with this dress. It's torn.
Oh no. She must have been wearing it. He killed her and then he took it back off?
No, there's no blood on it. It must have been torn some other time.
What? What are you thinking?
This is the same dress as the one in the book about Snow. I think Smith was dressing Lily up in it. To recreate the snow from the book.
You're right.
Wow.
It's the same dress. It fits. He's acting out scenes from the book. That poor girl. She couldn't have known. She probably just needed the money. She could have been anyone. How did she wind up here? I mean, not exactly here, but just how does a person...
We can't know the answer to that. Every situation is different.
Yeah. She must have been so scared.
Yeah.
Bigby, this? I think I heard this music last night. It was playing pretty loudly for a while, and then stopped in the middle. I didn't think twice about it at the time. I mean, you hear all kinds of things around here, and I guess I've already gotten used to blocking them out.
Could have covered up the sound of the murder.
Wow.
Maybe she didn't see it coming.
Maybe not. Oh, this is as far as I can go. Thank you.
Get it together, Beauty. Be strong.
Alright, I don't think there's anything else. Oh, apparently there is. Apple.
Do you smell something?
No, just apple.
Oh no, there's more? What? What now?
It's got a single bite taken out of it, like in Snow's story.
Oh no, do you think it was poisoned?
It wasn't. I'd have smelled that. I think it's just a prop. It's here because they were acting out the scene in the book.
Of course. That makes perfect sense. He's just acting out another part of the book. God, I can see the whole picture now. It all goes together like you said. This creep put that girl in a Snow White dress and
I don't know what that was, but wow.
Story from the book with the apple and the deep sleep and everything. You're a better detective than I thought you'd be.
Thanks.
So he planned it all out. He had all the details noted down. Only then, when it comes time to kiss her and wake her up.
Yeah.
I hope you're just about through. I don't really want to stay in here any longer.
I found a letter. An envelope. Wow, the music suddenly got loud.
Are those pictures of the dead girl?
Not all of them.
How do you know?
I'm in this one. It was taken last winter.
Oh no. Bigby. This kind of stalking, it doesn't just stop by itself. Trust me, I know about this firsthand. He'll keep trying to get closer and closer.
His stand-in for Snow is gone now, so...
The next step closer. What is it?
It's... Crane.
Oh, crap. Wow. Did not see that coming. Kidding, I saw that coming, but... Wow.
He could be after you now.
Good! I am dying to get my hands on that disgusting weasel!
He's a weasel, alright.
Starting to like you, Sheriff. You're not afraid to be a complete bastard.
Never afraid.
Obviously, there will have to be some changes.
Hello, Bigby.
Hello.
Take care of it, Bigby, or I'll take care of it for you.
Jeez.
Jesus Christ, Bigby. Is that you?
There you have it. Alrighty. You and 30.4% of players ignored him. How did you treat? So me and 45% treated him good. We let Snow come with us. Most of us hit him. Cool. That's it. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If it makes you clear, the like button. Join me next time as we start episode 3, where we do the halfway point for the story. So, we got some major realizations this episode, so I'm hoping that the next few start to, connect some of the other dots that were missing. So this is going to be Dactra and myself signing out. Until next time, see ya.